Made famous by its cheeky narrator, Come Dine With Me is a quirky TV One program that sees five people from all walks of life host a dinner party at each other's houses.
So, over the next 4 weeks, the Saturday Breakfast team has taken on the challenge in a bid to be the host with the most. Now, this week we kick it off at the lovely Toni's house. Check this out.
Take three C-grade celebs, a petulant poster boy, a bulky bean counter, and the host of a popular karaoke contest, and send them to a dinner party hosted by a heavily pregnant retired netball commentator. So, what can we expect? Some awkward silences, a dodgy contestant, and a hormonal host.
I'm really stressed out.
And then sit back and watch as they secretly score the host's dinner party.
First impressions?
They look like they've been involved in some kind of car crash.
Too salty and a bit too crispy.
So, come dine with me. So, Toni, what's on the menu?
For main, stuffed chicken breast with bacon and apricot jus.
Could be tricky, actually.
Now, Tamati is vegetarian.
It's not just about subtracting the meat. You've still got to have some flavours in there.
You're not really winning any friends with salad, are you?
And Street's signature sea salt fries.
I do love fries on the table.
The dessert, chocolate fondant.
Fondant.
Chocolate fondant.
Fondant.
Homemade whiskey crunch ice cream.
You'd always back a pregnant lady to do well on dessert.
Hey, nice to see you.
Good.
So let's see how long it takes to become awkward.
Take a seat.
Okay, all right.
Oh no, this is so stressful.
Yep, we're there. Time for some social lubrication.
What should we talk about at dinner?
You're supposed to come up with something really thoughtful and intelligent, haven't you?
Well, all right, let's bang around the NASDAQ.
All right, tell me about the NASDAQ.
Maybe we could talk about your thoughts on Māori water rights and ownership.
Oh, this is awkward. Toni, how far away is dinner?
Sadly, the chicken's not even in the oven.
Can't leave your guests going away hungry. I just hope they don't fill up on their mains and then they can't fit in the chocolate fondant.
Fondant, God save me.
20 minutes, and that should be done.
What about that salad?
Barefoot and pregnant, stressed out.
Pregnant? You're about to pop.
Oh!
That was lucky.
This is Tamati's frittata here.
It is.
So it's looking okay.
If you say so.
Stack it up with mushrooms. And wrap it in carrot just so that it basically looks better.
So we don't have to look at it.
Maybe time to do some detective work.
So while our host cooks, it's time for the awkward tour of the house.
Oh, I can't judge you for that.
He thrusts a sheet of paper at me. It's handwritten.
The Winner's Bible. One of those self-help inspirational books, but not just one. Three copies!
How gorgeous does she look there?
That's a real Beyonce moment.
Beyonce? More like Rod Stewart.
How many pillows are on that bed?
Are we allowed to go through the drawers?
I don't know about that.
Uh-oh, looks like Toni's chicken isn't the only edible fancy in the house. Back to the cooking.
Hopefully, Tamati will like mushrooms.
Not mushroom in the pan with all that butter.
I think the mains should be nailed, but then I've got the fondant.
Fondant. At last.
Lurking away in the background.
Toni, breathless. Her guests just hungry. Probably petal. How about some burnt chips? With snot, thanks, Tamati.
Must be the roses.
Or it might just be the smoke coming off those chips.
Was that funny? And while the boys get bored, Toni's getting hot and bothered in the kitchen.
I hate to serve up more chicken.
Toni may worry about poisoning her guests, but a hand wash may be nice. At last, 2 hours later, time to eat. No, not yet, wait.
Do you want some booze?
I take my apron off, I'm a bit hot.
And we're ready.
Whatever's on the top of it.
Did mother never tell you to eat with your mouth closed?
I'm assuming it's cheese, bacon and onion. It's outstanding.
Like your manners, Sam.
Some women never get back there.
Of course they don't.
Dad's not going to be me.
Of course they don't. You've been stretched out of proportion.
And it was just starting to go so well.
This is my whiskey crunch ice cream.
My ice cream, Toni. What does Mr. Tip Top think about that?
Actually, ice cream. Made from scratch.
It is made from scratch.
My Tip Top.
You're on the whiskey ice cream. All good.
I'm going to be hammered by the end of this. First impressions, burnt chips, not such a good idea.
The chicken, it looked and tasted fantastic.
I was really sceptical that it was homemade because it was just so good.
Well, tonight I'm going to be giving Toni a 8.
I'm going with that.
I'm going to give you 8.5.
But at the end of the day, I'm still very sober. And when I go to a party, I like to get crazy.
Which means with scores of 8, 8, and 8.5, Toni's grand total, a very respectable 24.5 out of 30.
I don't even know what to say about that. Do you know how creepy it is having people go through your house? I was like, oh, I hope they're not going to find anything dodgy.
And that's just part of it. Of course, then there's the actual meal side of it as well.
I know. It was really stressful.
She keeps saying it's really easy to make ice cream from scratch. And I'm like, really?
No, it is. It is. That was probably the easiest thing on that menu. Yeah. As for the fondant.
You know, it's still a lovely gesture to have us around. The only thing is that we were judging you.
You were. Wait till it's your turn, pal. Tamadies is next. Now, obviously, that was very much inspired by the fantastic TV One program, Come Dine With Me. And over the next few weeks, we'll show you Tamadies, Nadine, and Sam's attempts. Heaven help us. But the real version of the show screens tonight on TV One at 7:30, so make sure you look out for that one.